Miss Lester Romani said is the truth. The principal told me that she saw my son's video of being bullied, but she did not think it was important to act because they had not put.
Hello guys, I'm glad to have you all back on The Relatable with Bisola. Please, if you haven't subscribed, do remember to hit on the subscribe button and then tap on notification bell so that as soon as I post a video, you do not get to miss any of my videos. So every one of my subscribers, I want to say big thank you to each and every one of you for the support so far. Today we'll talk about a leaked video of a Zoom meeting by Darwin College parents and a former guidance and counselor of the school. He was a staff of Darwin College for 9 years and he has a lot to say about this issue of bullying. A parent has also narrated her own experience of how her 11 years old son was severely beaten just like Sylvester. The only difference was that her son was lucky and Sylvester wasn't. So I'll leave you guys to watch this video, and after which I'll be back for more updates on Oromoni's investigation, and then we can even analyze and talk about this video a bit.
My name is Samuel. I was a guidance counselor for. I hope you can hear me. I was a guidance counselor for many years, and I want to say right away that I worked at Darwin College for several years. One of the problems we have with most of the boarding houses today is that the structures are not built as, I mean, they're not purpose built for boarding houses. I might be referring to Darwin College. Now, a situation where you have several stories, several floors, and then no floor has a house parent monitoring the students. By the time you hear a sound and you go upstairs, the seniors have changed the story. That's exactly what happened at Darwin College. From the first day, they moved the students out of hired buildings into the permanent hostel. It was a time bomb waiting. Eventually, I resigned and I left them. I went to A-Hall from Darwin College because of that situation. The children are not well monitored. I shouldn't say too much about the place.
I'm sorry to say, why are you saying it now when it's time?
Secondly,
why did you not say things? Why are you saying it now? My son was bullied. I almost died in Darwin College. Why did you not speak out now? Why did you not speak out then? Died has died now. And now you are talking, you worked, you saw this thing for 9 years. Then you left this school.
And I resigned because of
that. My son is the victim. They did exactly what they did to
the second life. Problem,
but
madam.
Boy, they put up the line. They beat him. They were dancing around. They carried a box on his head. Valentine, He's so fat, he cannot climb up. He's downstairs. Ahmed, the house master, he doesn't climb up. The only grace that the guest hostel has is because of a lady they call Selim. Madam Selim, she's the woman in guest hostel. So she put discipline. You cannot bully in guest hostel in Dowen College. But you see the boys hostel, that third floor is the den where they commit the havoc. These children are bad. Everything Sylvester Romani said is the truth. They should arrest Ahmed. They should arrest Valentine. These are the housekeepers. The principal told me that she saw my son's video of being bullied, but she did not think it was important to act because they had not posted it online. She saw it and she slept on it. And you are telling me that you knew and you people allowed us to bring in our children. You collect 3 million for school fees and they don't put ordinary CCTV camera. They cannot put ordinary CCTV camera. My 11-year-old child just left home in September and they bullied him, they tortured him, they battered him. Seven boys, including Benjamin Favor, who was named in Sylvester Romani's case. And you are telling me you are away. What kind of a father are you?
Very much.
After watching this video, one would agree with me that bullying has been part and parcel of Dowen College, Lekki. But the authority took it with levity, they were indifferent and lackadaisical about it, and never thought that there was a need to handle it with proper care. And now we see where it has resulted into. Frankly, we know that every private organization has been set up first and foremost for profit making. However, I mean, Dowen College should have realized that the first reason why people would bring their words children into the school is because they want their lives molded. That is, Dowen lost it a long time ago. From that particular video that we watched, you could see how parents were, you know, narrating, giving their own stories. The principal never saw a need, you know, to throw in disciplinary measures to curb bullying and beating. The good news is, the five students whom Sylvester Oromoni Jr. mentioned before he passed on have all been arrested. Also, three housemasters have also been arrested and have been put in police custody. And this has been confirmed by the Commissioner of Police in Lagos State. Finally, I would like to inform you all that we should be glad that the Oromonis have, you know, hired the service of a senior advocate of Nigeria in person of Femi Falana. And I can assure you all that with this particular lawyer, we can all beat our hands on the chest and await justice. Well, that'll be all for now, and I'll see you on another episode of The Relatable with Bisola. Thanks and many more thanks for watching. Bye for now.